Hello everyone, welcome to this first video in the series of GeoGebra tutorials for mathematics explorations. Before we begin, a very brief overview of GeoGebra. It is a free educational application with its own repository of files that you can download from geogebratube.org. The interface has a graphics view, an algebra view, and a spreadsheet view. And the graphics view can be viewed either in two dimensions or as a three-dimensional view. Constructions in GeoGebra can be made using the toolbar, which functions like a compass box, or through the input bar, where you define the function from which the geometric object can be constructed. Referencing a construction, you can also type text using the text box in English or in any other Indian language. It is possible to change the parameters of a construction with the use of a feature called the sliders, which makes animating the file possible, and this makes it a very powerful tool in the classrooms. To help teachers in resource creation as well as for supporting transactions in the classroom, a series of videos have been planned in this series. The first one of which will be on labeling, display, moving, formatting, and measurement of objects. In the subsequent videos, we will be looking at the use of a text box and an input bar, the use of sliders, the use of a checkbox, the use of an input box for taking in student input for driving the construction, as well as the use of spreadsheets. We will also be having short videos on lessons using GeoGebra. These will not be complete 40-minute lessons, but other short videos which give an overview of the possibilities using GeoGebra. So now a little bit more detail about the content of this first video. We will be looking at the following in this video: on how to label an object, how to format an object, how to change the display properties of an object, multiple ways of moving an object, and different ways of measurements of an object. Now I will move on to GeoGebra window. So I'm going to pause for a minute while I bring up the GeoGebra application. So this, as you're familiar with, is a GeoGebra interface. This is the graphics view. If you desire to see the algebra view, you can go to view, click on algebra, and you can see the algebra view. For this tutorial, we will not be needing the algebra view, so I'm going to close it. And I'm also going to show you how to increase the font size so that you can also do it and it makes it more visible and readability becomes better. So you go to options, you go to font size and choose the font that you would prefer. I'm going to choose font 20. Now we will start with plotting a few objects and labeling them and formatting them. So we'll start with a point. So I plotted a point here, and a point here, and a point here. And I'm going to draw a segment. Now, I need to label point 1, 2, 3. And I need to label the two segments that have been formed. And I need to label the angles formed. So now let's look at how to label the objects. I can go to this point and I can label it in one of two ways. I can do a right click and I see the show label, or I can select the object. If you see something like this happening, it is because GeoGebra is still trying to draw a segment. As you can see, the segment tool is still highlighted. So GeoGebra is still trying to draw a segment. To get out of the tool that has been selected, you need to go and click this arrow here, which is also the move button. So once you click it, you've released the mouse from the previous function that it was already doing, which in this case was the segment. So now let's go back to labeling. So I'm going to select this object here and I'm going to go to the top panel here and I'm going to say name. You can also choose to make the point appear in any one of these shapes. You can also change the color of the point. You can also choose to see how the label has to appear. It's only the name, or you want the value, or you want only the value, or you would like a caption. So right now we will stick to only the name. And here I will use the right click option to show the label. Notice that the top panel for labeling gives you all the options here, whereas the right click shows you only one label option where only the name appears. However, you can go to object properties and there you can choose the different options for labeling the object. So now I'll also label this. So now we have labeled the 3 points. Now we also want to label the segment. So to label the segment, I select it. Notice that when I select an object, the object becomes bolder. Same here. So when I do this and I select name, I get the name here. When I do this, I select the name, I get the name here. Now let us say I want to change the color of the segment. Basically, I want to change the display properties. I want to format it. Again, I can do it with object properties after right clicking and go to color or style. So I'll go to line style and I will go to color and I will make it deep red. So I can see that it is become dashed lines in red color. The reason why the dashed line is not so showing very clearly is because this segment is still highlighted. So now if I move it to highlighting this segment, you can very clearly see the dotted lines of this segment. Now we will do the same for this. We will use the panel here. I will use dashed and dotted lines and I will choose a blue color. So now we have labeled the segments. We have formatted the segments. Now we still need to measure the angle formed. So for that, we will need to go to this option here, which shows the symbol angle. There is a drop down option here. So we will select the first one called the angle and it says select 3 points or 2 lines. So you'll select 3 points and you can select the arrow here to move this so that it becomes more visible. Now let us say you want to make this angle shape look a little bigger. You know, sometimes we have that requirement when we are teaching. So we go to object properties. Again, you can do it in the top panel also. I prefer to do it with object properties. You go there and you go to color and style. And here you can increase the size. So the reason why the fonts are sort of overlapping is because of the font size that I have chosen. But in your own computer, you don't need to choose this font size. You can choose a lesser font size. So you will see that the size of the angle is here. So now watch what happens. So it's become a little bigger. Now you can also change the colors here. So let us say you decide to change it to red. And let us say you also want to change the symbol that it shows. Let us say you want to show this. So you can do that as well. It's obvious, it's visible here, whatever changes I'm making in this object properties panel. The next important thing that we must remember is GeoGebra always functions with the same logic that we will use when we are defining mathematical functions or processes. So when we say angle, it automatically measures angle in an anti-clockwise way, which is a normal way in which we measure. So therefore, when it says select 3 points or 2 lines, you select the 3 points in this order, B, A, and C. Now let's see what happens if I selected the points in a different order. Let us say if I selected C, A, and B. So I get the reflex angle. Now this is also useful to demonstrate for students. So I'm just moving this point A so that it's more clearly visible. Yeah. So now this reflex angle is formed here and I want to format this as well. So let us say I go here and I want to change the style to something like this. And I want to change the color to, let us say, yeah. So now you can see that the color has changed and the size has changed and the display of the angle has also changed. So now we have seen how to measure the angle and how to display the angle as well. So the last thing before we conclude the tutorial is to see how to move an object. Now let's say I want to move this point. So I have to make sure that I select this move tool, which is this leftmost arrow, and then I come to the object that I want to move and I can use the mouse to move. Or in the case of a point, I can select the point and use my right arrow, my left arrow, my top arrow, or my bottom arrow. This is possible to do in the case of a point. Now let's say we want to move the segment. So let's say we want to move this segment. So you sort of move it like this, you can move it like this. If you want to rotate the segment, you can do so by changing the point only. You cannot rotate the segment, obviously, because that's not the way the segment has been defined here. The points have been defined and then the segment has been defined. So therefore, you can rotate the segment only by moving the point, but you can move the segment up and down or right and left by just selecting it with the mouse. So that brings us to the end of this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we will see how to create text boxes. Happy explorations with GeoGebra.